ask you guys, raise your hand if you have a pretty set daily schedule or just a familiar routine that you go through each day. Okay. Everybody in the class, we have our set routines. It's familiar, it's consistent. So what are some of the things that fills your guys' day?
Student government and that kind of thing. So, scholarship job. And
family.
Yes. Family. Okay, anything else? Or is this pretty much a general consensus of what kind of takes time in our day? Okay. So it's a pretty decent list. It's pretty consistent for everyone. So I'm just going to give you guys kind of an overview of what my schedule looks like, just so we can all be on the same page. I know you guys all have your schedules. But today we're just kind of talking about what keeps us busy and how we need to take a break from that busyness. So my daily schedule, I'm a little OCD, so it's really organized, and that's okay. That's me. I embrace it. So you guys look at my schedule. Wake up at 6:30 or so. That doesn't always happen, but that's the goal. Work in the morning. 10:30 to 11, there's a break. 11 to 12:15 is preaching. 12:15 to 12:30, short break before my next class. And then I have a short break before I go back to work. And then from about 5 to 6:30, I have another break in there. And then I have my scheduled workout time. And from about 8 o'clock on, it's everything else that we've listed. Food, homework, cleaning, all the other responsibilities of being a young college student. So, you guys, looking at my schedule, there's four places where I have break filled in. And generally, what do you guys think of when you think, oh, I have a break, like break time?
Eat. Quick nap.
Quick nap. It's free time, right? It's supposed to be free time. But, like I said, I'm a little OCD, I'm really busy all the time, so my breaks generally consist of, so let's see, what can I get done between this period and this period before I go to my next class, or before I go to work? What homework do I have that I can probably squeeze in this 15-minute time slot and move on? So my breaks really don't count as breaks, I kind of fill them with every other little filler that I can. And multitasking. If I can get two things done at the same time, then it's great. I've just accomplished so much more in my day. So I'm going to show you guys a quick little video clip that it's one of my favorite movies, and it's just kind of fun, and it shows another example of what this busy schedule looks like.
Oh, come on, Pascal. Oh, come on, Pascal. It's not so bad in there.
Can you guys see it?
The usual morning lineup. Start on the chores and sweep till the floor's all clean. Polish and wax, do laundry and mop and shine up. Sweep again and by then it's like 7:15. And so I'll read a book or maybe two or three. I'll add a few new paintings to my gallery. I'll play guitar and knit and cook and bake safely. Just wonder why. Just puzzles and darts and baking. Pure shape, a bit of ballet and chess. Pottery and ventriloquy candle making. Then I'll stretch, maybe sketch, take a climb, go and dress. And I'll be reading the books if I have time to spare. I'll paint the wall some more. I'm sure there's room somewhere. And then I'll brush and brush and brush.
she has her busy schedule. Not that she has too many options. She doesn't really go anywhere, if you guys know the story. She's kind of stuck there, but she does have her daily schedule, and it remains consistent. And so I'm a lot like Rapunzel's, got the same daily schedule going on. But I know that one thing that's missing from my day that I strive to work on but doesn't always happen is my time for devotions. And we're going to talk about that more in just a second. So let's turn in our Bibles, if you guys have them, or if not, I have it up on the screen. We're looking at Luke chapter 10, verses 38 through 42. So stay with me, visualize for just a second. We are in the home of Mary and Martha. Jesus has come to our house. He is he's hanging out with his disciples, you know, just chilling in the living room, talking. And Mary decides to go and join Jesus and sit with him and his disciples, talk to him, listen to him. So that's where she goes. Now we have Martha in the background, and Martha has an agenda. As Jesus and his disciples were on their way, he came to the village where a woman named Martha opened her home to him. She had a sister called Mary who sat at the Lord's feet listening to what he said. But Martha was distracted by all the preparations that had to be made. She came to him and asked, "Lord, don't you care that my sister has left me to do all the work by myself? Tell her to help me." "Martha, Martha," the Lord answered, "you are worried and upset about many things, but only one thing is needed. Mary has chosen what is better, and it will not be taken from her." So we have Martha, who it says she was distracted by all her preparations. She's busy, busy, busy. She feels like she has to clean, cook, prepare, set everything up. She wants everything to be well prepared for Jesus being there. And she strives to accomplish everything she needs to. But in the process of being busy, Martha neglects to engage with Jesus and take time to just sit down and be with Jesus. How many of you can say that you've gotten so busy, or you've blamed being so busy, or you've been so busy that you've blamed neglecting Jesus on that? Like, has there been a time when you just kind of, yeah, I know that for me, being in devotions and doing it consistently has always been something that I've struggled with keeping consistent. So looking back at the scripture, Martha gets frustrated. She's like, "Jesus, look at this girl. She's just sitting there. She's not helping me." And so she's like, "Jesus, tell her to help." So she's starting to put her amount of busyness on her sister. And she's like, "You know, I have to get all this stuff done. I need help." And like I said, being busy, I know I personally put blame on, "Well, I have to get this assignment done. I have to do homework." And I just put a lot of stuff in. It's easy for me to put a lot of stuff in first place before I take time out for my devotions. So towards the end of the scripture, Jesus responds by telling Martha that Mary chose the better way. And I think it's safe to say that at some point we all could have chosen the better way. I know it's important for us to get our homework done and our assignments, but it's also important for us to take that time in our devotions and just soak in Jesus' presence and just take time out from what we're doing, like stop everything, especially in the times of stress and busyness. I know this week was a big stress week for me, so just taking time out and stopping everything, putting that all on hold, and taking time for what's really important was something that I needed to focus on this week. So a pastor and close friend of mine has frequently used this quote for me, and he says that you need to take time out of your day, out of your busy schedule for God, and not make it. So I showed you guys my schedule earlier, and I said that I fill in my blanks, I make time for whatever I can, but you can't really throw devotions and throw God in those little spaces. Like, oh, I have this 15 minutes. Let me, this is my devotion time. That doesn't really work because it kind of defeats the purpose of embracing God and taking that time to be with Him. Taking time is just, like I was saying, removing a part of your days. You know, I'm going to stop what I'm doing. I'm going to be in prayer. I'm going to be in devotion and just sit in God's presence as Mary did in the scripture. So that's just a little tagline I want to leave with you guys. Take time and not make time. Martha took time to do everything else and was going to make time for Jesus when she was done with it. And Jesus can't be something that's just thrown on the side. It needs to be a priority. And as I've said, we just need to take time out of our day, out of our homework, out of, you know, even though maybe, oh, you know, like I haven't hung out with friends this week, like I've been really busy with homework. You know, maybe instead of doing something like that, like, you know, I need to put God first. But today I want to leave you with this question. Do you want to leave today being a Martha, working to accomplish everything else first? Or do you want to be a Mary, sitting at the feet of Jesus and soaking in His presence? Will you guys take time for God this week?